Hi, I'm Janet from World Anvil, and this is an absolute beginner's guide to using BBCode, or Bulletin Board Code, which is used for formatting text in World Anvil articles. BBCode allows you to do all sorts of cool things, like make your text bold, italic, or underlined, change the alignment of your text, create lists, and even to embed sound, so your readers and players can hear the soundtrack of your world or see images of the things that you're describing. It's really not that hard to use, and I'm going to walk you through the first steps. So let's get cracking and light up the forge. Bulletin board code, usually shortened to BB code, is a type of formatting code that uses square brackets to format your text. It's used by a lot of different websites, so it's a great skill to learn. And the good news is, it's pretty easy. So in this example, you can see that the editing interface uses BB code to make the text bold, italic, and small. You can use square brackets in the editing mode, and then you don't see them in the viewed mode. Cunning, huh? BB code has a beginning tag and an end tag, so the view mode knows when to start and stop the effect. These tags are always enclosed in square brackets. For example, using brackets B and brackets slash B makes the text between the code tags bold. In World Anvil, the easiest way to get started with using BB code in your worldbuilding articles is to select the text you want with your mouse and then click the buttons above the text box. So let's go through what each of these buttons does. These buttons allow you to make your text bold, italic, and underlined. The main header button will make your text into the font and size of the main header text in view mode. This is great if you want to create your own custom sections within an article. The secondary and tertiary headers will give you smaller texts, and they're great for subheadings. Paragraph bulletin board code will format your text into paragraphs, leaving a line between them. Subtext and supertext make the text small and align it with either the bottom or the top of the line. Small just makes the text appear a little bit smaller. This can give fun effects in your worldbuilding or prose. The break button makes a break appear in your line of text. Remember, the editing mode can't read your paragraph breaks unless you've used the paragraph BB code, so you'll need to use brackets BR whenever you want to start a new line. The horizontal rule, or HR button, adds a horizontal line into your text. This is useful for creating divisions between different sections of your work. The quotations button is a fantastic way to add another dimension to your articles. To make a simple quotation, just use brackets quote and brackets slash quote around your text. You can even take it to the next level and add an author to your quote. Simply write your quote text, use the vertical bar or pipe key, and then add the author name. These buttons will make your text align to the left, to the right, or in the center. You can also use the justified button. That means that both the left and right sides of your text will align, like this. Now let's talk about lists. They are super useful for presenting information in worldbuilding, and you can make two kinds: lists with numbers or lists with simple bullet points. Let's start with a bullet point list, called an unordered list. The tags for unordered lists are square brackets UL and square brackets slash UL. Add these at the beginning and end of your list to open and close it. It's easy to remember because UL stands for unordered list. Or you can just click the button. Adding items to your list is easy. For each item, open the line with square brackets LI, and then close each list item with square brackets slash LI. Writing an ordered list that is, with numbers instead of bullet points, works in exactly the same way, except that you open and close the list with brackets OL, you know, for ordered list, and brackets slash OL. You make the list items in the same way with brackets LI and brackets slash LI. Next, let's talk about adding pictures. All the images you've uploaded to your world's image gallery have unique ID codes. You can find this code by going to your gallery, selecting the picture you want, and clicking the clipboard icon beneath it. Now paste the link into an article. You should have something that looks like this. Brackets IMG, colon, and then a number. Congratulations! You've just embedded a picture into your article. Check it out in the view mode. You can link a URL easily too. Click the URL link button and paste the URL address after the equals sign. Between the two BBCode tags, write the text that you want the link to appear on. And voila! That's how it looks. If you want to share a song from Spotify, maybe a soundtrack or soundscape for your article, go to Spotify and select the Share option, then choose Copy Spotify URI. Now go back to your article and click the Spotify button, and paste the code after the colon. It should look like this in the editor, and like this in the view mode. YouTube tracks are even easier. First, copy the URL of the YouTube video. Now go back to your article, click the YouTube button, and paste the code after the colon. It should look like this in the editor, and like this in the view mode. This is great for soundtracks, but also for embedding your own music or spoken word recordings, and even recordings of, for example, your live play games. Spoiler markers are super easy to create as well, and they're a great way to warn your players or readers about sensitive or secret material which might ruin their experience. Click the spoiler button and write your content between the two BBCode tags. Spoilers automatically come up with the word spoiler, like this. And finally, if you want to write yourself notes, which only appear in the text editor and not in the view mode, click the padlock button and write between the stars. This is good for leaving yourself notes for later, and it's also great for people co-writing the same articles or worlds. Once you're feeling confident with BBCode, you can use the keyboard shortcuts Ctrl B for bold, Ctrl U for underline, Ctrl I for italic, and Ctrl Shift 1, 2, or 3 for headers 1, 2, or 3. If you want to keep track of your article as you're editing, I suggest having the edit mode open in one tab and the view mode open in another. Remember that you'll have to save the edit mode and then refresh the view mode in order to see your changes. Well, I hope this video has inspired you to use more BBCode in your articles and format the way that they present even further. If this video was helpful, leave us a like, and if it wasn't, please tell us why in the comments below so that we can make it better. Remember to subscribe for more world building content and also for more World Anvil tutorials. Alright guys, that's all from me today, so grab your hammer and go world build!